Good morning and welcome to this Wednesday Woo on self-respect. I decided to do this particularly because over the last few days I've heard a lot about loving yourself and self-worth, and I think sometimes they are difficult concepts to take on for yourself if you're not in that place of self-love or self-worth, and it can stop us from moving forward. When if we can take a different approach, we can think about ourselves differently. You don't, in my opinion, you don't have to love yourself to have self-respect. And I think self-respect can be so powerful because we know what it's like to respect other people. For instance, if your best friend is coming for the weekend, what are the things that you will do to make sure your home is comfortable and really ready to receive them? And do you give that same consideration to yourself on a day-to-day basis? And for me, that's not about self-love so much as self-respect. Do I love myself enough? Possibly not. Do I respect myself enough to change my environment, to do those things that I know are going to nurture me? And I think that is a different nuance that you can possibly try on to break through some of the blocks in your life. So that's what I wanted to cover today. And it's only my opinion. You can leave it, you can take it, you can try it, but trying things, just see how it goes. So self-respect is the foundation of a healthy, fulfilling life. And we're going to explore what that means, why it's important, and how you can cultivate it. So let's start by defining self-respect. It's more than making yourself or feeling confident. It's about honoring your own worth and dignity as a person. And I think asking that question in the moment, am I respecting myself, really does open up a door to how you're treating yourself. And are you treating yourself with the same kindness and consideration you'd offer to someone you deeply cared about, whether it's your children or your spouse or your partner? So why is self-respect important? Why does it matter so much? It sets the standards for how other people treat you. They'll treat you as well as you treat yourself. It helps you make decisions aligned with your values, with what's important to you. Because when you ask that question, am I respecting myself? You suddenly think about the things that are important. So for instance, your environment, as I say, if you have a guest and you're cleaning your house especially for them, what are the reasons you don't do that for yourself? You know, what are the values around that, and how can you create that to be more important for you? Recognizing your self-respect actually boosts your confidence and self-esteem because you're looking at yourself and you're acknowledging your presence, your value to the world. And it improves your relationships because you're showing up more of who you are and in a positive state. It's kind of if you have the victim mode or the person who's taking responsibility, you're showing up in full responsibility. In neuro-linguistic programming, it's cause and effect. If you're at the effect of something, you're living with the world and everything the world does is affecting you, rather than being at cause, where you recognize that you're taking ownership and full responsibility for your whatever you're doing, your value, your worth, for what you're putting out into the world. So that can really build your confidence and self-esteem, stepping into that responsibility, and as I say, improving relationships, because you're being more of who you truly are, and that also enhances your overall well-being and mental health, because you're standing in your power, you're looking at things from a different perspective. And some of the signs of low self-respect are constantly seeking approval from others. So again, looking to the outside world to see your worth, and having difficulty saying no or setting boundaries because you're looking for that positive reinforcement. You want to please others before you please yourself. And I think that's one of the things from self-respect, is that you begin to own what you want, and that you can have what you want and you can choose differently. And if you're tolerating disrespect or abuse from others, that's a real sign that you're not respecting yourself. And sometimes we can get into narcissistic or destructive relationships. And it's that moment that we choose that actually, I'm not putting up with this anymore. I'm going to respect my boundaries. I'm going to respect my choices, that we have the courage and the strength to walk away. Negative self-talk and self-criticism can really damage our self-respect. And sometimes that comes from the history of abusive relationships, if you like. And I know abusive is a strong word, but if you've been in a relationship where you're constantly being gaslighted or talked down to, then that really does disrespect you. And that constant negative self-talk and criticism that you potentially learn for yourself, and you learn to question yourself. It's really about, in those moments, thinking, you know, that one question can make the difference. Am I really respecting myself here? When you're neglecting your own needs and desires, again, it can come from all of this trauma and abuse and all of the things that we've learned. But just asking that question, what would it look like if I was respecting myself? If I was respecting myself, what would I want out of this situation? If I was respecting myself, what would I do differently here? So how to build self-respect? Here's a few tips on that. Practice self-compassion. It's treating yourself with kindness, and especially when you make mistakes. So stop yourself going into the negative self-talk and judgment and criticism, and just acknowledge what you've done so far in terms of how far you've already come. And if you make a mistake, what are you learning from it? That's really the question. What am I learning here, and what's next? How can I do it better next time? Set and maintain boundaries and learn to say no to things and don't align with your values or well-being. And also, maintaining your boundaries means choosing your network. I covered this in my Sunday newsletter, that the network of people you are with, it's a quote from Jim Rohn, that the five people you are with will set the standard for your life. And if you ask that question about self-respect, is that the standard you want to hold for yourself? You can choose something different with that. And that's around setting your boundaries as well, and living according to your values. So really, by identifying what your values are, this is something we go really deep into in neurolinguistic programming and coaching. So what's truly important to you, and making choices that reflect those values, becoming aware of your unconscious values is very, very important, because you may be carrying out behaviors that you don't understand, and knowing those values and that you can change your values if they aren't working quite the way you wanted them to. So understanding that is really, really powerful, because they can drive you in all areas of your life. Take care of yourself, prioritize your physical and mental health. And that includes nutrition, exercise, and general self-care as well. Taking moments out for meditation, taking moments out just to breathe can make a massive difference. And celebrate your achievements. We've covered this before as well, because the more that you acknowledge and celebrate your achievements, the more your unconscious mind will celebrate with you and look for more opportunities for you to succeed and achieve. So no matter how small, celebrate those achievements, and that also builds your confidence as well. I write mine down at the end of the day because I'm likely to forget them. And it's really good to look back when you're having a bad day and you've got a list of the achievements you've already had this week. So that's something that I think is important. And surround yourself with positive influences. So again, choosing those relationships that uplift you, that support you, that give you an example of what you want to aspire to. So, you know, have people in your network and have relationships with people who are already doing what you want to do or are on their way there to it. And that doesn't necessarily mean you actually definitely know them and contact them. It can be choosing to model someone. There's so much out on the internet these days that it's so much easier to model people because they're more open, especially mentor types. They're so much more open about how they achieved what they've achieved. And you can do that for free, or you can buy their courses, whichever works out for you. And a coach and mentor can really help you with that as well. And forgive yourself, let go of past mistakes and focus on growing and learning. I had this big light bulb moment this week around forgiving myself. I hadn't realized there was something I was holding on to. And it was quite an emotional moment to realize that I hadn't let go, and now was an opportunity to do so. So I'd love to hear from you if you have any questions about self-respect or any challenges you've faced in building self-respect or even self-confidence. You can discuss it in the chat, or if you want a one-to-one 20-minute call, I'm open for that as well. So just drop me a message. And thank you all for joining me today. Remember, building self-respect's a journey. It's not a destination. Be patient with yourself, practice techniques consistently, and just remember to ask yourself that question: is what I'm doing respecting myself? And watch how your life transforms. Until Friday, take care and respect yourself, and I'll see you on Friday. Oh, please do like, follow, and share, because it supports my channel. Thanks so much. Bye for now. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this week's episode. If you enjoyed it or think it would be valuable to others, please do share. And if you really enjoyed it, please leave me a review. It really helps the podcast. All of the links are in the show notes, and I look forward to seeing you next week on the Choosing Happy podcast.